Hi, I'm Rami Tamimi. If you've ever done any kind of survey leveling, then you know you're going to need to do some calculations. These include the height of the instrument setups, as well as the elevation of the points you were reading. And if you have any misclosure error, then you need to adjust those elevations. Today, I'm going to show you how to do those calculations using the backsights and foresight readings that you took in the field. Alright, so before we start, if you haven't seen my last video about differential leveling in the field, I want you to go and check that out. It shows you the full field procedure of how we collect backsight and foresight readings. The link to the video will be below in the description, or you can click on the corner right now and it'll take you to it. Once you've watched that video, come back here and I'll explain to you the calculations needed. Let's go ahead and take a look at some of the data we've collected. Now this right here is the project that we did last time. This is the manhole, which was the benchmark that we shot. The gate shot, which was the first turn point. Then there's the three points that we shot, orange, blue, and green. We shot the gate again, and then we shot the manhole again. I want to just emphasize that this manhole reading and this manhole reading are the same point. So don't be confused by the fact that they're on different lines. Same thing with this TP1 gate and this TP1 gate shot as well. Those are the same points. The reason we put these points on different lines is because they were recorded through different setups. Therefore, they have a different instrument height. However, the elevations in theory should be the same. And then the other thing I want to point out is these three points right here are considered side shots. Side shots are points that do not influence the instrument setup. What I mean by this, these points will not change the instrument height because we never took a backsight on any of these points. They were simply side shots, so we just took foresights. Side shots are like special points that we just need the specific elevation on. It could also be control points that we have record elevation on, and we may be in the field checking into one of them to make sure that our work is good. That's the use of a side shot. The reason I bring this up is I want you to make a slight alteration to your field notes. Since we never took any backsight readings on these points, what we're going to do now is take a look at the foresight reading, and I want you to copy that number into the backsight column. So the reason we're doing this is going to help our calculations and just make things a little bit smoother for us. To begin, let's calculate our error. And the way we do that is by taking the sum of the backsights minus the sum of the foresights. What we're going to do is we're going to calculate what the sum is. So that's 3.83 plus 3.73 plus 5.97 plus 3.19 plus 5.32 plus 4.35. Our total is 26.39. All right, now let's take the sum of the foresights. 4.50 plus 5.97 plus 3.19 plus 5.32 plus 3.71 plus 3.67. 26.36. So we have an error of 0.03. 0.03, that's 3/100ths of a foot. It's not bad. We're going to use this error to calculate what our adjusted elevations are going to be. But first, let's just figure out what the height of the instrument setups are and what the current elevations are. To do so, what we're going to do is start by taking the 795 benchmark elevation. This is given to us, and this is what we're going to base all of our work off of. To get the height of the instrument for the first setup, you're going to add the backsight to your elevation. So that's 795 plus 3.83 gives us 798.83. This is the height of the instrument at the time that we took this reading. Now, to calculate the elevation of TP1, we're going to subtract the foresight. So subtract 4.50 and we get 794.33. Okay, now we have our first elevation. To continue this process, we're going to do exactly the same thing. We're going to take the elevation of TP1 and we're going to add the backsight of TP1 and subtract the foresight of the next point. So 794.33, we're going to add 3.73. And now we have an HI of 798.06. Now we're going to subtract the foresight of orange minus 5.97. The elevation is 792.09. Now we're going to add the backside of orange, which is 5.97798.06. Hey, look, these two numbers are the same. Remember when I said side shots don't influence the instrument setup? This is what I'm talking about. Because the backsight and the foresight are exactly the same, whatever you subtract from the foresight, you're gonna add back into the backsight, and you're gonna get the same height of instrument. This is because we never actually moved the instrument. When we shot all these points, the instrument height was the same. I'm gonna go through the math just to prove to you that it's like this, but in reality, you wouldn't even have to do this because the instrument height would be exactly the same for all of those shots. The only time it's gonna change is when we picked up the instrument and we went back to check into the benchmark. Okay, let's keep going. So now we're going to subtract 3.19 to get the elevation of blue. Minus 3.19, 794.87. Now we will add back that 3.19, give us the same HI, 798.06. Now we're going to subtract 5.32. We have a new elevation of 792.74. Now we're going to add 5.32, same 798.06, minus 3.71, 794.35. Then we're going to add 4.35, and now we have a new HI, which is 798.70, minus 3.67 gives us 795.03. Okay, now you might be noticing a few things. First of all, TP1, which was the gate shot, and benchmark 1, the manhole shot, have different elevations on the bottom than they did on top. This is because of the error. Another way to check our error is to take the final elevation of the benchmark and subtract it from the initial elevation of the benchmark. When we do that, we get 795.03 minus 795.00 is equal to 0.03. And look, that's exactly the same. So we know that we've done our error calculations correctly. What do we do about this? How do we adjust the elevation? The formula to figure out the adjustment factor is actually quite simple. All it is the error divided by the number of stations. So what we have here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different stations. You don't count the initial benchmark reading. So we have 6 stations. And so what we're going to be doing is dividing our error by 6. So the formula is error divided by number of stations, and that looks like 0.03 divided by 6, which gives us 0.005. That is going to be our adjustment value. Adjustment is equal to 0.005. So now, because our final elevation of benchmark 1 is higher than the initial elevation, we are going to subtract this from our readings. In order to do this, you're going to look at the first station. The first station, you're going to subtract just the 0.005. The second one, you're going to subtract it twice, 0.01. The third station, 0.015. Fourth station, 0.02. Fifth station, 0.025. And the sixth station, 0.03. Now I understand that I'm kind of out of the box here, so forgive me. This looks a little sloppy. So what we should be getting here is 794.325. Here we're gonna get 792.08. Here we'll get 794.855. You could put a zero up here to stay consistent. This one is going to be 792.72794.325, and this last one's going to be 795.00. Okay, we've calculated our adjusted values. How do we know that this is now good? We can take a look at any numbers that are consistent. For example, the benchmark reading, which is up here, is now the same down here. So we know we're good there. And TP1, which is right here, is also down here. And these values are the same. So now we know our adjustment is good. And that, my friends, is how you calculate the height of the instrument, the elevations, and the adjusted elevations for your level loop. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and learned something new. If you have any kind of questions or problems, go ahead and email me. I try my best to respond to everyone's emails and kind of just get in touch with everyone. If you found this video to be informative, go ahead and give it a like. If you like this style of videos, go ahead and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I plan on talking about a lot of other things relating to surveying. But until then, I'll see you guys next time.